What is SpeedFan? SpeedFan is available for free as freeware. SpeedFan monitors voltages, fan speeds, and temperatures. SpeedFan can dynamically adjust fan speeds based on changing computer temperatures. SpeedFan runs on Windows 9X, ME, NT, 2000, 2003, XP, Vista, and 7. SpeedFan also has 64-bit support. Let's download and install SpeedFan. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter almico.com/speedfan.php and press enter. On the SpeedFan homepage, click on the download link. Under the download section, click the SpeedFan 4.45 link. On the download information bar, click the Run button. This will download the file and then automatically start the installer. On the SpeedFan Setup License Agreement window, read the license agreement, and then click the I Agree button. On the component screen, leave all the options selected, and then click the Next button. On the Install Directory screen, click the Install button. Once the installation finishes, click the Close button. You can start SpeedFan in one of two ways. Option 1, double-click on the SpeedFan icon on the desktop. Option 2, click the Windows Start button, All Programs, SpeedFan, and then click the SpeedFan icon. The hint window will open. Click the Do Not Show Again option, and click the Close button. By default, SpeedFan uses Celsius and not Fahrenheit like we do in the United States. Let's change this to Fahrenheit before we start looking at setting up SpeedFan. On the Readings tab, click the Configure button. On the Configure window that opens, click the Options tab. Click the Radio button to select Fahrenheit, and click the OK button. We can now see that all of the temperatures change from Celsius to Fahrenheit. Let's review the reading screen. In the top of the screen, you'll have the output window that'll show a log of the items scanned and found. Below this, you'll see a bar graph representing each core in the CPU. There are three graphs showing here because I have three cores on the AMD Phenom 2 X3 720 processor running in this computer. To the right, you have two buttons. The Minimize button will minimize SpeedFan to the system tray, but will remain running. By clicking that button, we'll see that the icon for SpeedFan in the taskbar will disappear when we click it to minimize. You can open SpeedFan back up by clicking the SpeedFan icon in the system tray. By default, Windows only shows a small portion of the items running in the system tray. If you don't see the SpeedFan icon, then click the Show Hidden Icons button. Click the Customize link on the Notification Area icon window that opens. Find SpeedFan in the list, and then change the dropdown so that it says Show Icons and Notifications. And then click the OK button. We'll open SpeedFan back up by double-clicking on the icon in the system tray. Below the Minimize button, we have the Configure button that has all the settings for the application. We will go over this a little bit more later. In the middle of the screen, we have all the fan speeds in the left pane and all the temperatures in the right pane. Below the speed and temperature information, we have the controllable fans in the system listed. This will typically be the fan connections on the motherboard. My motherboard supports 6 fans, but I'm only running 3. By default, the speed for all the fans is set to 100%. At the bottom of the screen, we have information on the voltages of various components. The Clock tab is used to overclock your processor. There are much better programs for overclocking, so I would recommend avoiding this option with SpeedFan. The Exotics tab is rather interesting. If you don't see anything, click the Show the Magic button. You'll get a nice view of all the different settings being monitored. The Smart tab allows you to view the smart information of your disk drives. Selecting any drive will show information like the error rate, spin-up time, seek error, and so on. The Charts tab will allow you to graph temperatures, fan speeds, and voltages. Clicking any of the options will start to graph the item with their own unique color. This is really useful to fine-tune the fan speed control to the exact temperature patterns of your system. Now that we've reviewed the available information in SpeedFan, let's get into using it to control the speed of our fans. Back on the Readings tab, you can adjust the speed of your fans by reducing the settings manually here. If you use a static setting for the fans here, you will want to set this to graph the temperatures on the Charts tab, then run a game or other application that will stress your system. After running it for about 15 minutes, take a look at your readings. If any of the temperatures get higher than you'd like, then adjust the fan speed higher. In addition to being able to manually set static speeds, you can also set the fans to increase and decrease in speed based on varying temperature readings. Let's click on the Configure button. The Configure window will open. You can select which temperatures, fans, and voltages to monitor with the first three tabs. The Options tab has settings you might want to adjust to your liking. If you have trouble with anything, you might want to come back here to the Log tab, click to select the enabled option, and then see if any additional information on your problem is shown. The only thing that we're going to go over in detail is the Fan Control tab. Click to select Advanced Fan Control. Here we set up thresholds for temperatures and fan speed. Typically, you'll want to create a separate rule for each fan in your system. This system has three fans, as we saw before. We'll create a rule for each of the three fans. Now let's click the Add button, and we'll create three different controllers. Enter a name for each one. We'll call them Fan 4, Fan 5, and Fan 6. After creating the three controllers, we'll select Fan 4. We now get additional information at the bottom of the window for each of the controllers. We'll click to select Controlled Speed. Now click the drop-down to show the available fans. And we'll select the first fan we want to control. In this case, Speed 4. Now we need to tell this controller for Fan 4 what speed it needs to run at for each temperature setting. Under Temperatures, we'll click the Add button. The Select Temperature window will open. Select the temperature you want to use to control the fan. Temp 2 is the temperature on my computer chassis. We'll select Temp 2, and then click the OK button. We'll go and set up the other two fan controllers in the same way. Now if we click on one of the entries under Temperature, we'll see a graph with the temperature and the corresponding fan speeds. You can adjust these by clicking on the graph. Each one of these dots tells the system at what temperature the fan should be at what speed. Once everything is complete and set up to your liking, click the OK button. Now before the automatic control settings take over, you need to click to select Automatic Fan Speed. We can see that as soon as I click this button, fan speed changes from 100% down to 42%. This is based on the fact that the temperature is 104 degrees Fahrenheit at the Temp 2 monitor. based off the chart that we saw before. At 102 degrees, it's set to run at 42%. If the temperature increases, the speed of the fans will increase. Okay, so at this point we should have SpeedFan installed and configured correctly. As it is now, we would have to start SpeedFan each time we restart Windows manually. Here we will create a shortcut for SpeedFan and place it in the Windows startup directory. This way, every time Windows starts and logs in, SpeedFan will automatically start up. We'll click on the Windows Start button. All programs. We'll find the startup entry, right-click, and select Open All Users. A Windows Explorer window will open. Any shortcuts placed in this folder will run after the Windows desktop loads. Let's right-click, select New, and then Shortcut. On the Create Shortcut window that opens, click the Browse button. Unless you change the default install location, select the C drive, Program Files x86, SpeedFan, and then we'll select SpeedFan.exe, clicking the OK button. It should now read C, Program Files x86, SpeedFan, SpeedFan.exe. Click the Next button. If you want, you can change the name. We'll change it to just SpeedFan, and then click the Finish button. There is now a new shortcut in the Startup folder for SpeedFan. Now every time a user logs into the system, it'll start SpeedFan automatically. The only other thing we need to change is to set SpeedFan to start minimized, so we don't have to click the Minimize button every time. We'll open SpeedFan back up from the system tray. Click the Configure button. On the Options tab, click the Select Start Minimized, and then click the OK button. So it turns out after I set this up that the temperature started going up pretty drastically on the CPU. I originally thought that fans 4 through 6 were all computer chassis fans, but it turns out that fan number 5 is actually the CPU fan. So to change this, I'm going to go to Configure, Fan Control. I'll select my Fan 05 controller. Right now it's set to temp 2, which is the temperature of the internal of the chassis. We're going to remove this and set Fan 5 to monitor temp 1. Which is the CPU temperature. Click OK. And now if we click on it, we can see the new graph. Click OK to apply. And we'll now see that fan 5 has gone from 41% like the others up to 100%. The CPU is rather high at 167 degrees Fahrenheit now. So after this runs at 100% for a while, the temperature should drop back to a normal level. You should now have a good understanding of SpeedFan and its basic features. You should also have your system set up to properly be cooled, while being quieter than it was before.